I've never seen it.
They do, though.
You're overreacting.
Steven, they stare at me. Yesterday, I went into the village, and this old woman just stopped in the middle of the street and stared at me like I had two heads.
Oh, don't be so melodramatic.
I'm like a walking freak show. Oh, this place, it's so insular. I just don't understand how you grew up here.
Well, I was very different then. And they're not so bad, really.
That's easy for you to say.
Just give it a bloody chance, Kate. This was the deal. A year here, and we could be in with a real shot at Lassia.
Stephen!
Oh, Christ, it's Lantham.
Stephen Appleton, I thought it was you. What's all this about a Yank wife? Oh. Hello.
Two heads, Stephen. Hi, I'm Kate.
Appleton!
What are you doing here?
You thieving bastard. I knew it was you.
Listen, take everything you need. But then you have to leave. You don't understand. You can't be near me.
Painting these stupid little pictures. Stealing food. You always were a little prick.
Please, every second we're in proximity makes it worse. I'm a primary conduit.
You're a fucking disgrace. Come here!
Don't touch me! Get off!
What's going on?
Come in here! Lord,
get off!
Over
Sam.
Us! Thinking you're so much better
Sam,
than the rest of us!
No physical
you
contact!
You and your stupid fucking
Sam,
missus!
Stop
She's
it.
Better than any of you!
Sam? Sam?
Is he...
Meg, please.
Don't come near me!
Meg!
Charlie!
Meg, wait!
Don't touch me!
Please, you have to understand, it was an accident!
Get off her!
Let go, let's just go!
Charlie, you have to understand, it was an accident!
Just leave him! Leave him!
What have you done, Appleton, you bastard?
Come on, Charlie, let's just get out of here!
Meg, Charlie, please! When I was a kid, my dad found a fox. It had been hit by a car and couldn't walk anymore. My mum went spare, of course, made him keep it in the shed. He was already slipping away from us then. He spent hours with that fox, telling it all about Italy and the villages they bombed there. I was jealous, I think. The fox got more of my dad than I did. But it was dying, that was clear. So one day, I snuck out, took it a sandwich for food. I was only 8. when it bit me. I remember the anger, the shock, the hurt. Running in, screaming from the garden. My mum panicking about rabies. My dad beat it to death with a spade. Later I found him crying. "It done a Ken, son." That's what he said. "It done a Ken, it was hurting you. That's just a poor, dumb, dying animal. It doesn't know it's hurting us. Christ help us, it's left the valley. It's everywhere now. It's been 3 hours since the planes went over. I haven't been able to reach anyone on the shortwave. I'm beginning to think I may have made a terrible miscalculation. All alone again. Forever. Like before. You've taken everyone I've ever loved from me. You've made me do things I never even thought I was capable of. But if you think I'm coming with you... Kate? Wait. Stop. Kate.
This is Catherine Collins. I don't know if anyone will ever hear this. It's all over. I'm the only one left. the end is coming now. I'm not afraid. We have each other. We lived apart from them. We understand now our failure to touch, to belong. But it doesn't matter anymore. Everybody is gone, and we will join them. We are born apart, driftwood on the banks of an endless dark ocean, and we will be carried away by the swell soon enough. But in between, in the single day of living, that dancing in a strip of sunlight, we can find what we miss. The love that makes us whole. The imminence. Everybody found their other. This pattern is mine.